स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू द क्लास इंग्लिश ग्रामर विद जीवन सर। इन द सीरीज ऑफ मॉडल वर्ब्स एज आई गेव यू वीडियोज आफ्टर वीडियोज आई एम श्योर ऑफ दिस थिंग दैट यू मस्ट हैव अंडरस्टूड एंड मस्ट बी प्रैक्टिसिंग एट होम। लेट्स स्टार्ट समथिंग न्यू टूडे इन द सीरीज ऑफ बेसिक ग्रामर। टूडे आई हैव जस्ट ब्रॉट नॉन एक्शनल सेंटेंसेज टू यू। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट देम, वट आर दे, how do we compose them and all. Non-actional sentences, as through their name you can come to know, non-actional means where we will not find action verb. Non-actional sentence is a sentence in which no work is done. It's very clear, this is why it is called non-actional. It means the sentence will be without any action or work. Clear? Because it is non-actional sentence. So what kind of sentences must they be? Obviously the sentence which will not have any verb in them. Look at Hindi sentences. I have taken three Hindi sentences to just explain it. Dharmin sir acche vyakti hain. Mere paas ek kalam thi. Kaksha ek mein 40 vidyarthi hain. So these three sentences are telling you that there is no work in very first sentence. If you talk about second sentence, the work is not being found here. The same thing is applicable to third sentence. There is no work. Let's talk about these kinds of sentences, how we will compose them, what is the kinds of them and all. Okay. So non-actional sentences are mostly of three kinds. Descriptive sentence, place starting sentence and positional sentence. So let's today we will talk about descriptive sentence. Actually the video will be into three parts, means of the same series. I will give you the video, two more videos after this. Today we will cover only descriptive sentence. So what are called descriptive sentences? Descriptive non-actional sentence, the sentence is which describe good or bad quality of subject of the sentence. There is no work in the sentence. We just talk about the subject of the sentence. What makes him or her special or known to us? What does that mean? Descriptive sentences are those sentences which usually talk about the quality of subject. We usually, especially we means speaker, usually talks about somebody and about his quality which makes him very special among his common gender or common noun especially. What does that mean? Look at, try to understand this with this example. Lalit sir buddhiman vyakti hai. So there are so many Lalit sirs, but we are talking about that Lalit sir who is considered wise by us. This is the quality of Lalit sir. It means to say that this is the quality which makes him very special, which makes him identified, which makes us know about his being very special. And this particular adjective which has been used for Lalit sir is describing something special about Lalit sir. So look at, work is not going to be done here by Lalit sir here, but the speaker is going to talk something special about Lalit sir. Look at the rules to compose the sentence. At first we will use subject, you know very well. Subject means about whom we are talking about, or you can say that who, with the help of who we come to know about the subject. In earlier videos I have taught you how to recognize the subject in the sentence. So you can use kaun or kisne just before this word. Kaun buddhiman hai, the answer you are getting Lalit sir. So subject B. What does B means? There is a story of B. Just after subject we will use B. B means, look at these three things, ha, tha, ga. Ha means if the sentence has ha alphabet or have ha family alphabet at the end. B means is, r, m, there. If the sentence has, or the, if the sentence ends with tha family words or tha family alphabet, B means there, was, oblique, were, anything. and if the sentence ends with ga alphabet word or ga alphabet with the ga alphabet, in such condition be means will be oblique must be depending on the sense. I will explain it later on. Just after that you have to use a oblique n. When do we use a oblique n? As you know, I have already given you the video on article. You can go back to the channel and you can just check out use of articles. Article, I have taught you, if this noun is singular countable, we will use a oblique n just before adjective. And what is adjective? Adjective which is going to tell us about the special quality of subject. Like this, the structure of the sentence will be, look at, try to translate this non-external sentence, especially descriptive sentence, into English. At first you have to look for subject. Subject, how do you know? In the earlier videos I have taught you, kaun buddhiman hai, the answer you are getting, Lalit sir. B means look at, as I told you, the sentence ends with her family alphabet, it means B means will be, is oblique R oblique M. So obviously with Lalit sir, singular noun, that means is will be used by us as be verb. Then a oblique N we have to use when noun, singular countable noun, is given just after adjective. If this noun is not given, only adjective is given, in such case a oblique n is not used. I will give you the example of this one as well, don't worry. Look at, then adjective quality, which quality we are talking about, wise, and noun vyakti. So the sentence will be, Lalit sir is a wise man. Talk about second sentence, vah achhi thi. So obviously subject, kaun achhi thi, vah. So thi word is coming here, thi alphabet has been used by me, it means it's a girl, and for girl the pronoun we use she. Then B, what will be B here? Look at, the sentence ends with tha alphabet, it means to say that was oblique were, and you know with she pronoun we use singular verb, that means watch. Adjective is given here, achhi, that means good. Look at, noun is not given, so it is the condition, if noun is not given you will not use a oblique n. Okay, so the sentence will be simply she was good. Look at one more sentence, main ek achha vidyarthi hoon. Subject main, be verb will be, look at, the sentence ends with her family alphabet, it means is R M. Adjective achha, noun vidyarthi. So sentence will be, I, with I you know very well M is used, M, we will use a oblique N because adjective and just after we see noun. I am a good student. Hope you must have understood this. In case of not getting, you can comment and I will give you some other methods to understand this particular descriptive non-actional sentence. Thank you.